Hey guys, it's Thursday and July 21st. Today is going to be Navy SEALs Day, and instead of doing the 20 minute busy dad session, I'm going to do hopefully 10 rounds of 10 reps Navy SEALs with 3 push-ups and 10 squat chasers in between. And that'll give me 100 burpees total, 100 Navy SEALs total. I suspect it's gonna take me 30 minutes. It's definitely gonna be more than the 20 minute busy dad session. What I'm trying to do is give myself a break from the all out 20 minute sessions. At least every other workout. So earlier this week, Tuesday, I did 20 minute busy dad session for 98 reps of Navy SEALs. Yesterday I did a 6 count busy dad session. So today I want, it's not necessarily an easier session, but it's gonna be longer, more drawn out, with some micro goals within the macro goal of completion of the workout. So 10 reps, I'm gonna try to be somewhat aggressive on the 10 reps. Think about explosiveness and speed. Not concern myself with the pace. I'll use that to raise the heart rate. Then the push-ups and the squats, I'll lower the heart rate. I'll pause for 10, 15 seconds and go right back into it. And again, the goal is 10 rounds. So that'll give me 100 burpees, 100 Navy SEALs, and 330 push-ups and 100 squats, and probably call it a day with that, although I might do some dips. Nothing promised, we'll see. So that said, I got my notebook here, write down the rounds, and we're going to count down for 10 seconds. And then I'm going to get an additional 30 seconds before I actually start the round. Don't ask me why I do it that way. I just... Alright. There's the shirt. Sorry, 35 second countdown. Fluid throughout, set an even pace, not a real long pause in between everything. Just enough to take a breath, 2 breaths. And I'd like to finish around 30 minute mark, but again, who knows? Seven. Eight. Yeah. 4. 5. 6. 7. 8. 9. 10. 1 round. Six. Seven. Eight. I suspect I'm going to regret throwing those push-ups in. Six. Seven. Eight. Ten. 7, 8, 9, 10. 3 rounds. So a little bit of a cough. A little bit of congestion. But overall, I'm feeling better. Round 4. Coming up to the halfway mark. One. Two. Ten. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Halfway there. 5 rounds. Just occurred to me, I only set my timer for 20. So, it's gonna beep. When it beeps, I wanna remember, start my stopwatch. So at least I have a rough estimate of how long it was going. Round 6. Eight, 9, 10. Six rounds. Easy pace. Burpees are slowing down a bit. First few still feel pretty springy and explosive to be quickly replaced with the last 5 or 6 being kind of slow, but I'm getting it done. Round 7. Six. 7. Stopwatch. I have 19 minutes already on the clock. Let's see if I can do 3 rounds in a little over 10 minutes. Six. Stopwatch didn't go off. So, it's gonna be a guess. I think it's all from the tape. See if I can recapture some of that springiness from round 7 that seemed absent from round 8. Round 9 coming up. One. Two. Six. Down. One to go. That last set of seals started off strong. Pretty springy, pretty explosive. Six reps at least. I like how that feels. I've yet to be able to do six reps a minute for 20 minutes. I've gotten up to 11 minutes, and then dropped down to 5, and then 4, and then I think I finished off with 5. That was for my best Navy SEAL set in 20, which was 112. The closest to that was 107, which was about 3 weeks ago. Then it's been downhill, but I'm hoping to get those numbers back. I'm hoping workouts like this are going to add to my 20-minute total. So let's get that. Last round in. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. 10. Let's do two, maybe three easy sets of dips, 5 reps, with like 6 Navy SEAL, or sorry, 6 lunges. My brain's not working. Pardon me, guys. Cramped quarters in here. But it has everything I need, with the exception of squat rack, which unfortunately I left in my old house. Somebody else has claimed it. By the way, I believe I made it in under 30 minutes, 10 rounds. So, 5 push-ups, nice and springy. Springy seems to be the word for the day. 5 push-ups, 6 alternative lunges, which is just alternate lunges, which will just be 3 on each side. Nothing major. More than I said, but I was in a stride there. Give myself 30 seconds. Set number 2 coming up. I'm going to leave it 2 sets, mainly because I'm feeling pretty good. I'm going to end it on a high note, No need to push it. I'm happy with my Navy SEALs for the day. And I'm going to talk for a minute on equanimity. I think that's the true aim, true purpose of meditation. That's where peace lies. That's the best way, in my view, to navigate life. Because here's what I found in ultra running, here's what I found being 57 years old. You can't train to be tough. I have finished 100 mile races, but I have not finished more than I've completed. Was I tougher the ones that I finished than the ones that I hadn't finished? It's the same type of training, same body, same mindset. I went in thinking, planning for a finish, having a game plan, following it through. But something wasn't there. Mistakes were made. One race I was, unfortunately, allowed myself to get dehydrated, had to stop early, pushed as long as I could. But you can only push so far. People talk about, well, that an ultra is 30% physical, 70% mental, so that you can tough it out. But, you know, it's the same with a long set of burpees. Can you tough out a long set of burpees? Sometimes. Sometimes you can't. That's just life. Sometimes life is hard. So instead of training to be tough, here's what I found. When my body gives out, when my mind gives out, there's something else there. And that is equanimity. That is energy, spirit. We can call it the Tao. We can call it whatever you would like. But it's a energy that's beyond but includes the physical and the emotional and the mental. You don't have to be tough. The other day I talked about the water being the toughest element because it can crack through the strongest stone. The willow tree being one of the strongest trees because it bends within the breeze. That's spirit. That's who we are, the core of our being. And meditation brings out our equanimity. It brings out our true nature. It doesn't train us. So we're not training to be tough. We are training toughens the body, allows us to go farther. But when it gives out through the practice of meditation, through the practice of breath work, through energy work, we are reminding ourselves that beyond tough, we are resilient. We are equanimity at our core. And that's how, if you're doing a tough set of burpees and you're just about to give out, you push yourself to that mental edge, then relax, take a breath. Honestly, it's just a set of burpees. There's going to be much harder things in life. Speaking from sitting at my father's bedside, his very last breath, actually, holding his hand. There's a lot tougher things than running 100 miles. There's a lot tougher things than a set of burpees. And all the training in the world is not going to prepare you for that. But learning how to relax, learning how to breathe, learning how to be kind, most especially learning to be kind with yourself, because without recognizing your innate kindness, you don't have that to offer other people. And trust me when I say that kindness goes a long way, giving and being returned. And if you have equanimity, if you have some resilience, when you give kindness and it isn't always returned, then you're not broken by it. You don't wonder, what did I do wrong? Why doesn't this person like me? How come I didn't get kindness returned? I gave it out. You're kind because that's your nature. It's Let's liken it to an orange. If you squeeze an orange, you only get orange stuff. You get orange juice, you get orange pulp, you get the essence of an orange. When we are steeped in kindness, when we are steeped in resilience, when we're squeezed, and life will eventually squeeze all of us, kindness will come out. Our resilience will come out. And again, that's more important. Kindness is more important than 100 Navy SEALs, although 100 Navy SEALs is pretty damn important. I don't take any of this. I take it all lightly, but I do take it serious, otherwise I wouldn't be doing it every single day. But I did want to talk about resiliency. I did want to talk about the aim of meditation is to find that equanimity and be able to use it to navigate through our lives calmer and again kinder. That's been the true gift of meditation for me. And again, it's a practice. I do it every day. So I'm able to practice being resilient with myself, be easy with myself, to let things go. You know, I meditate, I watch my breath, I relax, and then I repeat the mantra. The mantra will come nice and easily, and then the we have thought. And then sometimes I let that thought go, and I'm in that very peaceful, quiet stillness. Other times my brain might catch that thought and hold on to it and then run in a wild direction of thought cascading after thought. But as soon as I notice, because at that real center, I'm the awareness that notices, I'm the witness. So when I notice it, when I witness it, I just come back and say the mantra, gently, easily, I repeat the mantra. And I slowly ease myself back into that still point, center, silence. That's meditation. It's not stopping the mind, it's not stopping thoughts. It's learning how to allow thoughts to flow through the openness, through the open nature of the mind. In Buddhism, it's likened to the clear sky nature, that the sky itself is always clear. It's always open. It's never affected by clouds. It's never affected by a storm. It may hold the storm. It will hold clouds, but it's never affected. That's our true nature. That's the Buddha mind. That's our clear sky mind. And you can notice that. You can just point that out. You can point at the sky and relate it to your own nature and know that we are included within that all-encompassing kindness in the sky. And with that, I'm going to end it. Thanks for watching. Thanks for tuning in. Anybody interested in learning meditation, just leave me a note. Reach out. I do it all virtually through the phone. And it's easy to learn, and it's a lifetime of practice and peacefulness that follows. So y'all guys have a good day. Take care. Peace.